do a quickie.
Yeah. So. Cool.
Wow. Kind of scared getting in here.
Compared to a pair of Chuck Taylors, this is definitely an upgrade. Absolutely amazing car.
Check out the start button.
Right here?
Yeah, nice.
And where's that launch button you were saying? Oh, here's the paddles.
This is nice.
I'm quite scared being in this car, so I think we'll wrap it up. This is amazing. I don't think I've ever been in a house that's worth this much money. So, awesome. A lot of Chuck Taylors could be bought for $2 million. So.
Okay, this is the Bugatti Veyron. It is the fastest car in the world, and it's a car that I had the opportunity to purchase in Germany about 6 or 8 weeks ago. It was over at the factory. This was one of their press cars, and it had about 7,000 miles on it. And they were reconditioning the car and making sure that it was perfect, and they went through it from front to back, and there's no stone chips, or they put new brakes on it, they put new wheels and tires and so forth. And it's virtually like brand spanking new, even though it does have 7,000 miles on it. Not that 7,000 miles is a lot, but on this kind of a car, that's a lot of miles. And I also have a McLaren F1. I've had that car for about 14 or 15 years. I bought it new. And that car today has 7,000 miles on it over a 15-year period. But you know, these are the kind of cars that you really don't drive them a lot. And I think that they're just a beautiful thing to look at. And when you do get to drive them, it's a thrill, but there aren't a lot of places that you can drive there. So, anyhow, that's the story on the Bugatti.